Welcome back to 10 Slide Info. Today is the day which is going to be a memorable or a painful or an unfortunate day for many people and defense lovers, as it would give many people a mixed feeling. Today, which is October 1st, 2021, is the day on which the Ordnance Factory Board will be dissolved as per the decision taken by the Union Cabinet. Yes, the Ordnance Factory Board will be dissolved with effect on Friday, October 1st, 2021, and the board's assets, the employees and management are being divided into 7 newly established defense public sector undertakings. The Ordnance Factory Board, consisting of the Indian Ordnance Factories, was an organization under the control of the Department of Defense Production, the Ministry of Defense and Government of India. Ordnance Factory Board was established during 1775 at Fort William of Kolkata, and in May 2020, Prime Minister Narendra Modi's government announced that it will dissolve the Ordnance Factory Board units. Even though 80,000 employees were threatening an indefinite strike against the move, nothing has helped to stop this particular dissolvement. Even though almost all the employees of the Ordnance Factory Board are being transferred to these new PSUs, there will be no change in their service conditions. All previous factories and employees will become a part of these 7 PSUs, and it is said that the pension liabilities of the retired and existing employees will be taken care by the government from the Defence Ministry's budget. The 7 public sector units are Munition India Limited, Armored Vehicles Nigam Limited, Advanced Weapons and Equipment India Limited, Troop Comforts Limited, Yantra India Limited, India Optel Limited and Gliders India Limited. The main reason for dissolving the Ordnance Factory Board into 7 public sector units is due to its poor performance and productivity when compared to other defense PSUs like BEML, HAL and BEL. Seeing one of the oldest entities of defense getting dissolved is really hurting, and that too a company which has been supplying critical arms and ammunition to the 3 defense forces and the paramilitary getting into this state is very bad. Anyway, everything happens for a good reason. So let's expect the new 7 PSUs, which is public sector units, to perform as expected and give the expected productivity. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned to 10 Slide Info for more defense and aviation related updates. Thank you.